Good morning, everyone. Today we shall begin with the still part two. It is also available for the first unit. As I had told you, it was completed. First part it is completed. I have made it to two parts. Okay, so you people will not get more difficulties. Part by part, you start learning here. Am I audible to you? Anyone, please respond.
Yes,
me?
Ma'am.
Okay, fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Huh. So the part two. Now we are going to begin with the database. So last class I had taken the kind of introduction for the database SQL. Okay, keep aside, that is also required. Small introduction I have given. Now which the concept I am going to teach you, which is very useful for your database. Last time you have learned that is the introduction for the part of SQL, and here today you are going to learn that is getting included in that part last class. Okay, so. Now to create a table, I will be telling you, I want the table, I want the student information, those who have taken above 90, this all stuff I want. I always keep on telling. So for that purpose, what all requirements are there to get structured? So today we will learn the concepts of the database management system. I mean database concept, very, very easy topic. If you learn this quickly, you will be able to cope up with errors. Yes. Errors, the word I have said here, because in every programming you will be having the errors. So you know the kind of errors, Java errors, what are those here, variable missing, this, semicolon, comma, expected, expressions. These are the different errors here. So similarly, you people are going to have the errors for your this one SQL DBMS. For that purpose, you are supposed to learn the concepts. Okay, what kind of error you will be getting and what is the name of that error? We are not going to learn only the errors here, but you should know the concept. Okay, so let us begin with this here, very easiest part. So what this contains, you are going to have the data models, then schema and instances, three schema architecture, data independence, and the last one, it is what database languages and interface. The last class I had taught you database languages, DML, then DDL, DCL, and DVL. These all things are only introduction and titles are given. But deeply, I have not went. Today, you have to check the data model, schemas, and instances. This schema and instances are going to be with you till the end of your SQL part here. If you are going to start working with your project for your sixth semester or so, it is going to come along with you itself. What is the instance? What is the schema? Bahut easy hai. And then three schema architecture. The three schema architecture is also similar to the data independence. Now, why I'm telling you that similar to the data independence? The reason it is that you yourself will start getting confusion. Three schema architecture is similar to the data independence. Yes, it is a kind of similar. So don't get tension. Don't worry here. We will be teaching you separate by separate here. Okay. And data independence also I have told you. Database language, you will be learning the different types of language. What are the database languages here? DDL, DML. Main part is there here. Okay. For that, what you are going to include, that you have to check. So let us begin now separately with the data model. Here, collection of ideas that are used to describe overall structure of the database. We have not yet started building the database, but I'm telling you entire database. Now I shall give you the example called as this what database of fourth semester A division. This is the database of the fourth semester A division. What you are going to do that? So what is the data model here? It is completely collection of ideas. Ideas, matlab, in your fourth semester A division database, what all ideas are going to include? Means what? Roll number, name, marks 1 to marks 5, or any other kind of relationship, like a second semester, third semester. So that ideas, which are used to describe the overall structure of a database here. Overall structure, tables, attributes, values, updation, deletion, insertion, everything it is there here. Just you can say overall structure of the database is called as data model. If they ask you the question here. What do you mean by data models? You can tell them overall structure of a database is also called as a data model. Okay. Then second bullet point, what they are saying, structure of database means type of a data. As I have told you that roll number, name, marks one, marks two, then grade, percentage, everything there. Okay. So the type of a data, matlab, roll number, what you are going to include? Are you people going to include the numbers also or alphabets also or both? I mean, alphanumeric. So that kind of a data you are supposed to specify. Then relationship among this data. This, what means it is? Relationship among this data means what? I have told you that from the first semester to the sixth semester or fourth semester, your university register number will never change, right? So that relation should be from your first semester to fourth semester. How the relationship is to be created here? Now suppose, let me give you the example. Assume, first semester you have created a roll number column, okay? And you have entered all the roll numbers here, everyone you have entered. Then you came to the second semester here, you entered everything. Third semester you came, and what happens in the third semester? You start entering some new values, right? Some new values here. But those values are not there for your second semester nor even the first semester. It will be confusion, right? So for that purpose, relationship should be there. Assume that. I have given one more example. Do you remember that? This what? A division 401 to 500. B division 501 to 600. These are the, which is already present in your database. Now, when you start entering the marks for your fourth semester itself, which is which are there from 401 to 500 and 501 to 600, from this only you have to enter the marks here. So what happens? Just a minute. Okay. Okay, so between that 401 to 500 and 501 to 600, if you are trying to enter the roll number 601, automatically database will tell you that 601 roll number is not available. Please check the value. For this purpose, you should have the relationship. Getting, still you will not get kind of students, my God, this is what exactly the relationship is. I have not yet started actually in the database yet. So you should be aware what roll number is present and what you are trying to enter the value. You should get matched from your first semester to the fourth semester here. Okay. Then restriction which is applied to the data. Yes. Restrictions means will be like the size of the data or data type. That is what called as a restrictions will be there. You cannot change the data sometimes. You cannot delete the data sometimes because in your first semester it is being created. If you directly delete the first semester's roll number, it is about to affect for your second semester, for your third semester, fourth semester. If you go vice versa, I mean descending order, if you try to delete in between only third semester, but it is going to get affected for second semester as well as first semester and fourth semester. So that is what called as a restriction, which is applied to the data here. Many things are there in the database. You will be learning step by step where I'll take extra lab classes also here. Not to worry in that here, okay? And then most of the data models also describe the basic operations applied to the database. Kind of operations means what? It is like updating, retrieving here. You can update the data, you can insert the data, you can delete the data. These are the operations here, okay? And the last bullet point specifies that data model is to show how we can hide some details of a database from the users that is not needed by the user. Means what? It is like a data abstraction. Now suppose I will give the authority for the Sai Prakash only to insert the data. His job is not to delete here and his job is not to or what update here, only insertion. Otherwise, I'll give the authority to Maitri to read the data of fourth semester, only to read the data of the fourth semester year. She don't have authority to read the data of the third semester year. So we are supposed to hide the details of third semester, second semester and fourth semester from Maitri. She should be only reading the data of the fourth semester year. So what they have said, how can we hide the some details of a database from the users that is not needed by the user? Now we are people are going to register for the vaccination purpose. Do we know that how those people are storing our data here? No, we just are entering our name, then our age, then our this what date of birth, everything, address, everything we are doing. Do we know how they are storing? No, we don't need this. That's what it is called as a hiding some details of the database from the users that is not needed by the user. Okay, only what we part. We want that much it is visible here. So this is your data model. What the exactly the definition of data model? It is describing the overall structure of a database. Sufficient. If they ask you the question, what is a database model? Please tell them only describing the overall structure of the database. Sufficient. If they ask, what is this overall? You have to tell them that type of a data you have included, the relationship you are going to maintain with the different tables, and the last one, it is what? Restriction. Bas, utna hi. Okay. So this is the data model over. Then second topic. Yes. There are three types of a data models, which is very, very easiest here. So three types are what? High level or conceptual. Now let me tell you. These data models, whatever you people are going to learn, no, it is going to be similar, which will be similar to the three schema architecture as well as data independence also. So if you learn now what types of data model, it will be very helpful for your next topics here. Okay. So the first type of a data model, it is what? High level or conceptual data models. Second type of a data model, it is low level or physical level here. And the third one, it is what? Implementation. All you people can say it as a this what? Representation here. How people are going to use it? Yeah, okay. So have a look for the all the types of a data model, which will be very easy. So now here, let me tell you, assume that you people have a database. Your fourth semester, I'm telling you, you are going to have the database of your fourth semester. You have decided to create of your class database here. Okay. So for that, how you are going to apply this all the types of data model? First one data model, high level, what it specifies, you know, or conceptual. Read there. It describes that what data is to be stored and how can we retrieve that data. Conceptual matlab, what and how. Okay, repeating, I'm repeating. Conceptual means what and how it can be accessed here. You have decided to create a database of your fourth semester. So now for the conceptual, what you have to do? You have to decide what data you're going to include, means roll number you're going to include, name, then marks 1, marks 2, marks 3, marks 4, marks 5. You have decided to do this here. How can we retrieve that data? Once you have included all the records like Sai Prakash, Maitri, Renuka, this all data which you are going to include, those data, how you people are going to access it? That is what called as a high level or conceptual data. Actually, data nahi hai aapke paas. Sirf aap decide kar rahe kya dalna hai aapko aur access karna kya hai. That it is there here. Only deciding part is done in your this what conceptual data model. Then second type of a data model, it is called as a low level or physical data model. What is this here? It describes how data is to be stored in the computer. Please don't get confused between how can we retrieve. In the previous one, conceptual data model, it is how you people are going to access. Now in this physical means what you have to decide how this data, how the Sai Prakash, then his roll number, his all 5 marks, how they are going to get stored, what type of a data you people are data type you are going to include. Roll number ke liye aap integer hi dalna chahte ho ya var kya dalna chahte ho. For the name, what is the size of the name, how many alphabets can be fixed here. So that you have to decide. And in the previous one, high level of conceptual, what आपको रोल नंबर डालना है या नेम डालना है या मार्क्स वन मार्क्स टू, दिस इज व्हाट कॉल्ड एज अ हाई लेवल ऑफ कंसेप्शन. फिजिकल मींस व्हाट, हाउ, रिमेंबर इन योर माइंड, कंसेप्शन इज इक्वल टू व्हाट, फिजिकल मींस व्हाट इक्वल टू हाउ, सफिशिएंट. ओके, देन लास्ट वन इट इज व्हाट, रिप्रेजेंटेशनल और इम्प्लीमेंटेशनल, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन डेटा मॉडल. इम्प्लीमेंटेशन मींस व्हाट, आपके पास अभी डेटा आ गया, assume that now your fourth semester database is ready completely with your roll number, name, also the records here. What exactly now this representational data model? Read this. Between these two models, representational model is some which hides some details of data storage and some represent to the end user. Now it is going to apply the queries here. Assume that already database is available. They have said that which hides some details. Assume that I am going to access your database and I want only student names and percentage. Fine. I want only student name and percentage. I am not interested for your roll number nor your marks here. So whatever roll number and all the marks should be hide from me. I think it should not be visible for me. So I say only I want to check only name and marks, percentage, sufficient. So how that data model will take care of it? When I start using queries here, that should be decided here. Getting means what? In your high level, we will decide, we will create. In your physical level, we will put some data. In your representational or implementation, I will be questioning. I want the students only those who have scored 90 marks, sufficient. बाकी का सब्जेक्ट का कुछ भी नहीं चाहिए मुझे. So that is what called as a implementational model here. Getting? So what was the data model here? It is the overall structure of the database and different types of data model are what? Three types are there. Those are high level of conception, is equal to what data. Okay. And second type of a data, it is what? Low level or physical data model, is equal to how data. What is high, when what equal to high and how equal to low. Getting? And the last one, representational model, take care of this two, both high level or low level. Aapko access karse karna hai. Or hiding the details, which is not necessary for the users. Getting? These are the three types of a data model. And next topic, it is what? Yes, now we have to begin with your database SQL view, kind of. So they will ask you the question, what is a table? I will be saying that what is the different name for table that year. Okay. Still many more names are the table. I'm telling always table, table, table. Table one is first semester, table two is the second semester, table three is third semester, table four is fourth semester. I was murmuring this year. So what exactly this year? Now we have to begin with this year. Data model schema and instance here. So you schema, you should not say schema, okay? Anybody there in the class, Sima? I think not there, which is, she is in sixth semester. So it is not Sima, it is a schema. Let's see. Fine. So schema means what? A database schema is the skeleton structure of a database. Please don't get confused between the database model and schema here. Again, it is a skeleton structure, they have said, overall database. Thoda to similar aa jayega. But actually, it is not a overall database. Nahi hai. Kush, database mein aur ek kush to hai, a structure hai. Getting, let me tell you now, soon. Database schema is a skeleton structure of the database here. Okay. It represents the logical view of the entire database. Now, this logical view will be included in your database independence. So, keep calm. Soon, we have to begin here. It represents the logical view of the entire database here. Only this word logical view here. The overall design of a database is also called as a schema. Overall design of the database is also called as a schema here. Please don't get confused between the database model and schema. Still, the time is there. What you have to learn here. It is like a structure of the table. I will tell you, it is like a structure of the table here, or skeleton of the table here. What all things you are going to include in the table? So that, and then what do we mean by instance? Instance is what the data which is stored in a database at a particular moment of time is called an instance of the database here. Now, already creation of the table is done. Schema ready hai. Schema ke mein kya kya hai? Fourth semester here. So what all things you are going to include? This is what roll number, name, then marks 1 to marks 5, grade, percentage, grade. These all things you have decided to include here. So this is your schema. Now, actually what data you are going to include? Roll number 501, name, Sai Prakash, then marks 1 to marks 5, all these marks here, and percentage 94, percentage, and then grade A+, whatever it is in. So these are all from the Sai Prakash data, detail, whatever we are including here, that is what called as a instance, which is stored at the moment of time. It is called as an instance of the database. Getting? Structure, sirf table ka structure create karna aapko. Data matlab actually record or actual value you are going to insert, that is an instance here. Getting? And still there is an alternate name for the schema as well as this what instance is available here. So don't get confused between all these different names. Soon I will be telling you different names also here. Okay. Then see, now we are in the structure. Can you see here? This is the schema, all this student, course, prerequisite, then section, grade report. These are the schema here. I call it a student schema. So you have to tell me inside the student schema, what are the, this is not record, guys. This is not the records. Records will come when I say below name, Sai Prakash, student number 501, class 4th semester. Major means what, in which subject he has taken. Or you can give anything, not a issue compulsory that you have to give this and that. Okay, so this is the schema, only structure of the table. Jab isme data aayega name ke andar, so that will become this what, instance here. Now, one more, let me tell you. Okay, here. In the course, course name, course number, credit hours means how many hours we are going to take that subject, or how many hours your subject it is, and department, which is it. Now, guys, you see here, prerequisite here, it is there, see. Course number and prerequisite number, it is there. Course number is available in the course also here, course schema, course table B. So, a course number, this course number, and this course number of your prerequisite should be always matched here. So, that is what called as a relationship among the data. I'm repeating, relationship among the data. See here, in the course number is available, and in the prerequisite, course number is also available. Also, see, section also here also, this what course number is there here. So all these three course numbers should be matched here. If you give here 1 to 5, and if you start giving your sixth course number, it will not include, guys, because whatever you have included here in the main course part, so that should be always matched here. If you want to insert new course number, so you have to insert first in the course number, course, then come to this all other parts here. Getting? And see here, the student number is available here, as I said, 501 to 600, and before that 401 to 500. So if these are the numbers are there. If you try to enter in the grade report, the roll number as a student number as 601, it will not include, guys. That should be between the range of numbers which are being included in your student schema or student table here. So that should be always matched here. Getting? So these are the relationship, and only similar kind of, I'll tell you here, when you're going to include student number in the student table, so this we have to call it as a PK matlab primary key. Okay, not a movie name here, PK, primary key. And when you're going to include this grade report here, you have to say FK, which is called as a foreign key. Getting? Which is called as a foreign key here. And when you use the course number, this is a PK. And when you're going to come for this schema or this table, this is a FK, which is called as a foreign key. Matlab, ye is table ka refer kar raha hai. Still, don't get tense, be calm. Soon I'm going to tell about your lab section also here. PK, FK, what is that here? Very, very easy. Okay, so this is a schema. Instance kab aayega? Jab values aayenge. Name ke niche cipher ka student number 501, class is 4 semester, and major it is what? CS, any kind. So that's it. Then third topic, let me give the difference between the schema and instances here. Schema means what? Visual representation of a database, which is a set of rules that govern the database. Set of rules matlab name, what kind of a data type should be? It should be string. I mean varchar. What kind of a student number should be here? It should be numbers or mixture or alphabet. Class is also size should be given. What type of a data bit here? Okay. So only visual representation. Isme kuch data nahi aaya. Sirf representation hai. Then what exactly the instance is, what data stored in the database at a particular time. Now inside this, when I say CyberCache, when I put CyberCache 501 for semester CS or JAV, whatever his highest level mark is, that. Okay, that is what the data inserted in the database at the moment of a time or a particular time here. Okay, then formal description of the structure of the database. You are supposed to give the description here. Name up cases structure kare. Your C programming, you will say int a comma b. This is what description it is there. You are saying that a is representing the data type of integer and it has a size of 4 bytes 2 bytes. That is up to you. That should be the description here. And set of information stored in the database at a particular time. How many values are going to store here? That and does not change frequently. Last difference is what? Does not change frequently. See, this all the name, student number, class, major, it will remain same till you decide to add the extra this word name, one more column. I cannot tell you still. Attribute I'll not tell. Okay, add the one more column here. Frequently it is changed here. I mean not frequently, bar bar change nahi hota, but instance changes frequently. Why? Because assume that here one more phone number is there here. So at the starting time I have included CyberCache 501, class 4 semester, and major Java. And here, and after now third semester he is taken as a Java. In the fourth semester his highest marks will be DBMS. So this is what getting the changed, or some other information is getting added. So that time it is what called as a changes frequently getting. So these are the differences between the schema versus instances here. Okay, next one, third topic, it is what? Three schema architecture. Very, very easy it is. Three schema architecture. I'll just give the introduction and we'll wind up. Not to worry. Three means what? Three layers. Okay, three levels. Please let me begin before this word three schema architecture. You should be able to understand what is the data models, types of data models. Same it is there in the three schema architecture. So kind of same it is. So let us start here. Three means what? Three layers are there. Three schema architecture, don't say that three schemas are there in your class. No, no, it is not. It is a three schema architecture. It is also called as an ANSI or SPARC architecture or three level architecture. In the examination, they will ask you directly explain the three schema architecture sufficient. What it is? It is again describing the structure of the database. It is again describing the structure of a specific database. I can say it is about to describe the structure of your fourth semester database. In your fourth semester database, what all things you are going to include? How you are going to include? How it is getting stored? So this is what the three schema architecture. Three schema architecture contains three levels. I mean, breaks the database down into three different categories. Soon we have to begin with this three levels are there. So I'll change the slide. Have a look till then for 20 seconds. Have a look. Three levels are present. Same with the conceptual level, physical level, and internal level. Three levels are there: external, conceptual level, and internal level, and then databases. So let me tell you about your first level, highest level. It is called as a external schema, or you can call it as a external level also. And then second, it is what, conceptual schema or conceptual level. What was the conceptual level? It was what, data. And internal level, I mean low level also you can say, okay, it is how data, it is about the story. And one more thing, it is available, see, right side. Conceptual and external mapping. Mapping means what? Ye jo levels hai na, external level, conceptual level, or internal level. Ek dusre ke saath communicate kar rahe. They are communicating with each other. Assume that here is the Sai Prakash. Here Sai Prakash is sitting, and here Maitri, then here Renuka, and here Aishwarya. I'm giving the example, don't take it seriously. What happens? Aishwarya will ask that, I want to check the details of the students' TBMS mark. She will ask to whom? She is not going to communicate directly to the Sai Prakash. She has to take the help of this what, Renuka, where Renuka will request to Maitri. Maitri will ask to this what, here it is. Waiter. This Sai Prakash. Then Sai Prakash will go on responding to Maitri internal level. Maitri will go and responding to this what, Renuka. This is what happens here. Okay. Then let us begin here. What mapping matlab request karna, ek dusre ke saath communicate karna, transfer karna. So it is going to begin from the internal level. The internal level has an internal schema which describes the physical storage structure of the database. Here physical storage, database kaisa store hota hai aur datas kya kya rehte hain. The internal schema is also known as physical schema here. How? See, it uses the physical data model. I had told you in the beginning itself, you should be aware of the types of the data model explanation here. Conceptual matlab, what data is getting stored and how it can be accessed. Physical matlab, how, kaise data store ho raha hai. Getting, so we'll go back again here. Ha. It uses the physical data model. How data is getting stored here. It is used to define how the data will be stored in a block. Are you people getting here? How it will be stored here. She will collect all the data. Sai Prakash aise waise sab kuch collect karti hai. Baad mein Sai Prakash ke paas deti. And Sai Prakash will take care of your fourth semester database here. Okay? The physical level is used to describe the complex low level data structures in a detail. Matlab, relationships will be different tables. So that they are going to describe. What exactly internal level is what? It is showing you physical storage structure of the database. It is describing how the data is getting stored. And it is also called as physical schema. Sufficient. Okay. And the next one, conceptual level. Conceptual level is like a high level. Okay. So let us start here. The conceptual schema describes the design of a database at the conceptual level. It's also known as logical level. Conceptual schema describes the structure of the whole database. Pura structure hai unke paas, but data nahi hai, only structure hai. Structure matlab kya kya aega? Dissolves structures. Only this conceptual level will take care of this, all the structure of all the schemas, all the tables. They are not having the values for this. Once they have the value, so that will become the spot internal level here. Then conceptual level describes what data are to be stored in the database. Name, roll number, student number, major, department, and also describes what relationship exists among those data. The course number is present in the course. It is getting represented in prerequisite. It is also getting represented in section also. So these all the relationships should be there here. Okay, then in the conceptual level, internal details such as implementation of the data structure are hidden. Internal details matlab kya kya hai? Name ke liye aap data type kaun sa use kar rahe ho? Role number ke liye aap data type kaun sa use kar rahe? That should not be represented here. Okay, and last point, reprogrammers and database administrators work at this level here, who are actually working on the database. Those people will work here. And the last one, external level. What is this external level? Which is completely outside. Take a look for that. Very easy thing is. The external level describes, contains several schemas that sometimes also called as a sub schema here. मतलब schema का sub schema हो जाएगा. The sub schema is used to describe different view of the database. I have told in the beginning, I want to view only the database like this one, name and percentage. My view is that. And Chaitakash wants to view the name, marks of all subject and percentage. That is his view. So external matlab kya? It is a subset of the database or subset of a sub schema. And external schema is also known as view schema. And what it is, I think time is very less, so you people please give the attendance here. Very less here. I'll be continuing in the next class. Yesterday I have forwarded most of your first unit part 1 collected stat reading. To complete your entire first unit, still I need 2 classes.